This tutorial is a continuation of part one. We will now examine the test code and run the application with and without dynamic binding to show the difference in behavior. We are now at the root of the test hierarchy. Here we derive a test case class from standard and provide it with a pointer attribute to enable connection to the unit under test. Setup case is needed. And here we declare the test case scenarios on the object. Registration and name must be implemented. Here we reserve an area in memory for croot so that we can get an access from its alias, that is, from local root. Here we establish a connection to root. These are the test case scenario bodies. The object parameter is specific, not a class-wide type. And the methods setValue1, setValue2, etc. are dispatched, but in a static manner. Yeah, the test case wrappers declare class-wide wrappers for each test case scenario on the test case. The register test procedure expects each test case scenario to have a class-wide type parameter. When inheritance is not used, the parameter is the standard class, that is aunit.testcases.testcaseTickClass. When inheritance is used, we pass a specific class-wide test case. In register tests, we instantiate the package STC from the generic package specific test case registration using the test case class as the generic parameter. STC exports the procedure register wrapper, which is used here. In which case we can now register the wrappers, each of which contains a test case scenario. And here's name to identify the test case by name. Branch test case inherits from the root test case. We need setup case. Note that setup case is only available with standard. Well, as you may recall, the scenarios on the fixture test case are treated as independent tests, which are isolated from each other. With fixture, the tests are called and run as standalone routines. Hence, there is no test group concept, and therefore no need for setup case. The disadvantage of using fixture to test object-oriented designs is that the established connection code in setup must be run for each test routine, which of course is not as efficient as calling it just once as is done here. So here we establish a connection to cbranch. And here's our test case scenarios. In the test sum of squares, this new method is primitive and local to branch, and therefore a narrowing conversion is necessary to access it. It's the body of the test case scenario wrappers. Mustn't forget to include the inherited methods. There's just one override and one new to register. And finally, here's the complete registration section. And test case scenario exports register wrapper. Once again, and we name this test case. Well, there's only one function here, so in principle we could do away with the package and eliminate a file. But then we would know, we'd have to import root.test to see test suite. I normally prefer the use of child packages to provide modularization benefit. Anyway, it's a matter of programming style, not important to this tutorial. Here we add the root test case to the new suite. And we add the branch test case to the new suite. Here we add the sub-test suites to the new top-level test suite. And here's our main program, which we're ready to run. So we'll execute this, we'll compile and build. And run. And here we see that everything ran without any errors. Also the GNAT coverage shows that we didn't miss any test code. All the test code exercised all the units under test. Now if we go back to the root and if we comment this out, remove this comment. Likewise in the body. Remove these comments here. And comment out this block. And compile everything again. This time we see that the test sum of squares called the method in C branch, which returned a dummy value, which caused the assertion to fail. So this proved that we did indeed access the method on branch, the overridden get value 2 on branch. Okay, this concludes the tutorial testing a class hierarchy with a standard test case class.